The big mover now in the broader markets is ICICI Prudential. It's up almost about 9-odd% and massive volume seen in that name. So just look at ICICI Prudential now. In fact, you know, it's across the board. I mean, a lot of financials are moving. IndusInd Bank we spoke about. Bharat Financial Inclusion is up almost about 4-odd% as well. That stock is looking pretty good. It should be up for you on your screen. And from the infrastructure space, Dilip Buildcon is one stock that has been gaining so much ground. It's up 60% this year and almost about 4-odd% or so this morning as well. But GMR Infra is the stock on our radar. It has sold stake in their airports business to the Tata Group, GIC and SSG Capital Management. My colleague Nisha Podar caught up with Saurav Chawla, the Executive Director of GMR Group, and Sushil Modi, the Group CFO of the group, to understand the rationale behind the deal. Here's a slice of that conversation.
Our debt as on December, our quarterly announced results, the debt number was ballpark 20,000 crore. Effectively, the debt goes down by the entire 8,000 crore because the primary proceeds that comes into the GMR Airport Limited, that also will be utilized to repay some of the debt that was sitting at the GMR Airport Limited. So net-net, the 7,000 of secondary proceeds as well as the 1,000 crore of primary proceeds, both combined 8,000 crore, reduces the leverage or the debt that was sitting in the GMR consolidated numbers of 20,000 crore. So our debt in one shot goes down from 20,000 crore to 12,000 crore. And yes, to the extent that we provide exit to our existing investor, yeah, to that extent it will increase some bit. But yeah, but the substance, sum and substance is the debt goes down substantially to 12,000 odd crore. And if I may add a little better clarity, more important in this 20,000 crore debt, or henceforth the 12,000 crore debt, was the corporate debt or a corporate leverage that was there at GMR Infrastructure Limited at a holding company level, and which was obviously invested into the various businesses from time to time to grow them. So that number, if you see from our results, was in the ballpark range of 6,500 odd crores. So the 7,000 crore of secondary proceeds which comes to the GMR Infrastructure, in a way, effectively, if you see on a pro forma basis, that kind of completely cleans out, wipes out the corporate debt. The rest of the debt which are sitting, so it means the 12,000 crore, which is basically against various projects like airport projects or a different highway projects. So those are all, in any case, on its own footing, you know, with the perfectly matched with the ongoing cash flow that keep accruing.
So can you throw more light also on the finance charges and how much will they come down by? Because we have seen in the past that your company is a bit positive, but at the bottom line, it gets negative because of the huge financial charges.
So the finance charges on a consolidated business was ballpark in the range of 2,000 odd crore. So now 8,000 crore that we get as an investment amount and repay our debt obligations. So to that extent, it is, if you just do a pro forma without going into the specific numbers, it takes out 1,000 plus odd crores from the finance charges. So the consolidated financials, the finance charges is going to kind of, you know, reduce more than half.
All right, more than half reduction in the finance charges. All right, let's talk about the deal then. Tata is coming in as a strategic investor and GIC is a big investor in the company. What are the governance rights, the board seat and the management control that the new investors have sought from the company in the airport business?
So this is pretty standard, right? Any investor, financial investor, whoever comes in and participates, so they look at more from a protective standpoint in terms of their value. But here it's what we are talking is not the rights in terms of protection and stuff. What is more important is how do they guide us and, you know, effectively value add in the business. And just for the understanding, GIC is a big investor in this airport infrastructure space globally. They have investment in Europe in a number of airports. So they are in fact going to add value in terms of their experience and their understanding of this space, which will effectively be getting synchronized along with our expertise that we have acquired. And again, our expertise is also, you know, has already gone global. It's no more restricted to India. As you know, we have presence in Philippines. We have recently won the airport concession in Europe as well, in Greece. And in the past, we have operated a Turkey airport. So effectively, net-net, both the partner and alongside the Tata, what kind of value add that they potentially can do. So all that combined, we are all set here to really grow this business phenomenally, adding and building block by block, taking inputs and the thoughts of each of the stakeholders.
Right. So any board seat that is being given to the new investors?
Yes, that's pretty customary, right? For a transaction of this size, the investors will have the board representation. But again,
how many?
More important is GMR continues to be at the helm. Continues to run the management and the operation of the business on an ongoing basis. No confusion there.
So how many board seats are going to the investors? And will Tata have a separate board representation here as well?
Yes, so each investor will get the board representations individually, yes.
And SSG also with 10% stake?
Yes.
Now you're at the brink of 54% stake by the parent company, GMR Infrastructure, in the airport business. How comfortable are you at this point in this, especially considering a lot more equity dilution may be required for pumping in more cash for expansion in the business as well?
The future growth in this space, the airport infrastructure space, is humongous, needless to say. But the point is, we have multiple levers in the business to capture this opportunity. So as you know that we hold 64% in Delhi Airport, we hold 63% in Hyderabad Airport, which we intend to take it to 74% by buying one of our strategic investor. And similarly, we have multiple other airport concessions in say Philippines, 40% Cebu Airport. And recently, we won another three airport concessions in India, the Goa, the Nagpur, and more recent, the Vizag. So net-net, we, depending upon how these opportunities shapes up, and more importantly, in terms of the size and the timing, we will suitably decide which levers really we need to activate. And the levers can be, one of the levers can be, we own, pretty much more than 50% in each, in all these airports. So we can definitely divest a minority, a small minority of 10-20% in some of these individual airports, and would have a good financial wherewithal to meet and grasp all the opportunities that comes along our way in this particular space.
In terms of monetization, and help me understand, the valuation at which the deal has been done, the equity valuation is 18,000 crore rupees. And you have also mentioned in the release that the earnouts valuation is 22,475 crore rupees. Can you explain the earnout basis of valuation calculation? And also, why is the equity valuation lower than what you had settled with your private equity investors late last year, which was 21,000 crore rupees?
Right. So in terms, you are right. So our post money valuation that we have agreed with our investors is 18,000 crore on a post money basis as a base value for today, and then we get another 4,500 odd crore in terms of the various earnouts, and with that the total post money valuation becomes 22,500 odd crore ballpark. So thereby our equity stake, once we buy out our existing investors, private equity investors, goes to 54 odd percent. And as and when we reach or achieve those earnouts, this 54% will go up to 62 odd percent ballpark. So coming to the specifics of the ratchet, these are pretty standard, as you know, in some of the performance metrics we agree amongst investors and the management, and as and when we deliver some of those operating metrics, and to just give you an example, like our duty-free performance in terms of how fast the revenue grows. Similarly, is our commercial real estate monetization in terms of the quantum and the timing. So some of those performance metrics, as we in our journey, we keep achieving, we keep hitting the milestones. And good would be to note that one of the important building block of this ratchet in terms of the commercial real estate, we have recently achieved in significant manner. As last week you would have noticed, we announced one of the monetization around our commercial real estate at Delhi.
So Nisha, just to add over here, it's a timing difference. So the investors feel that this should be done in a defined period of time, which we agree. We have very high degree of confidence that those will be achieved. So just because to bridge the timing difference, this earnout mechanism has been agreed. But effective valuation, we believe, and I think we will demonstrate that also as we go forward. Like Sushil just rightly said, in one of the cases, the earnout mechanism has almost been achieved in the last year's week's monetization of commercial assets. So I mean, these are timing differences which are being addressed in a structured manner. But from a valuation perspective, our numbers are northward of the 21,000 crores that the earlier transaction was announced for the buyout of the earlier private equity player.
Okay, we'll play you more of that conversation. But as we wind down on Bazaar, we leave the markets in a very, very strong position. Back to the highs of the morning. So to be sure, lots of long ideas on Chartbusters. From all of us here, thanks for watching Bazaar.